Hello YouTube, it's Thursday, December 29th. Thought I'd make a couple videos on the Secchi. I was going to make one video, but when I put them all together, they ended up being about 33 minutes long, and that's just the videos themselves. I stacked all the videos that you can get from the Secchi site together, and you can get those from right here. It goes by the year, and then it has the bi-monthly videos here. And I put those together in one video and ended up being 33 minutes long. So I'm going to try to follow along with it up here in Starry Night. I've got the Stereo A over here and Stereo B over here. Started out with the original position, the one that you should get right now, the current position, current orbit for Stereo A. And I tried to go back to the 2007 orbit for Stereo B because it has a few interesting things going on right after it's launched. Right after they were launched, Stereo A was put in an orbit closer to the Sun, and you can see it right here. Stereo B was farther from the Sun, so it's back and back of the Earth. The Earth's right down here. And when it gets started, you can see the Earth come up, and the Moon actually passes right across the Sun. And then as the Earth and the Moon moves on off the screen over here, you'll see it put on the same flaring activity that you see in Venus every time Venus gets close. You'll see the same flare, and it always points toward the center of the screen, and you also get a big reflection that's always opposite of the flare, always opposite of Venus from the center of the screen. But you'll see the Earth do the same thing back at late March, early April 2007. So the first few videos they have here at Secchi, they're not complete, and they skip around a lot, so you have to keep adjusting the times on them. We'll get it started here and synchronize the windows up. And as you see down here, we're already up to the 30th. They're already up to February now. The problem with using the current orbit for the stereos is not exactly correct. You see it puts the two planets here, Venus and Mercury, up a little bit higher than they're supposed to be. You see the flare right here already from Venus. And you'll see the stuff going on right here. That's the Earth and the Moon over here in Stereo B. And you'll see the Moon come across the Sun right about in this pass. Right there. And the Earth keeps moving on off to the side over there. And when it gets to the side and starts leaving the screen, you'll get to see nice little show it puts on. And here's the Earth right over here. It's moving off the field of view. Here's the Moon. This little thing right there is the Moon. And when it gets to the side of the screen, you'll see it put on the same flare that you see from Venus. This is the Moon over here. This is the Earth off the screen. And then it does this little number, and quite spectacular there. That happened right about the 1st of April. That's coming from the Earth. So, I'll take and stop that out there. And see what the other site had. I downloaded this from the other site. This looks like the raw FITS files here. I don't think they did any processing to this. But this is the Earth back on the 20th, 3/20th. Stereo B's looking at the Earth here. And you see the big long line. That's the saturation of the camera. This little dot over here is the Moon. And as it moves off, you'll see probably one of the biggest flares that you ever see. Here's your same thing you see with Venus. And you see it's opposite the center of the screen from the Earth. You see it putting out the flare here now, as it starts to leave the screen, and your little reflection over here leaving. And I can say here's the Moon over here. And this has to be the raw files, or close to it. There are not very much processing going on here. And boom. And you see that for a while. Obviously, the Secchi image is in process. This is about 3:30 here. You're seeing this enormous flare from the Earth. And that has to be the biggest flare I've ever seen on Stereo B. Finally, we're in April here now. Finally starts clearing out a little bit. You see the waves out here. It's the same waves you see on Sechi. Another wave over here. So that's about all you're gonna see. About the biggest reflection I've ever seen. So how far away was the Earth when it did that? Let's go back and look here. And it's still off the screen a little bit. So we'll bring it back to about there. And the way we've got it zoomed in here, it's about 24 degrees is the field of view of Sirius. So it's right about there. And it's 20 degrees total, up and down and sideways. So right around 10 degrees is the up and down that you're going to see. So it's right around in there. So how bright was the Earth? Well, it was a magnitude minus 8.7, and it was only 0.023 away from the observer, Stereo B. So usually Venus gets about 0.3 AU away from Stereo B and Stereo A, and this is much closer. This is 0.023, so it's over 10 times as close as what Venus gets. So that's why it put on such a show, and you'll see that show over here. And like I say, that's the biggest flare I've ever seen on stereo. And so we'll go back to the program here. And synchronize the windows up. And we're about 329 here. Let's go back to 41. So we'll get it going again. I had to take and stop it. I hit the wrong button, change it to today's date. And then we move it back to April 1st, and I moved the one over here to the current Stereo B orbit instead of the older one, so I wouldn't have to do it later. But you can see the Earth over here just out of the field of view, and here's your big reflection down here, big flare. So we'll get it started again and try to keep it in sync, but it's pretty hard. Seems like whenever stereo is up front, the starry night runs slower, and the other way around, when you put starry night up front, it runs faster. So, and then you got stereo jumping around also, sort of difficult to keep in sync. You can see all sorts of stuff going on from the Earth passage. Here goes your Comet Encke down here. And you're still seeing stuff over here on the screen from the Earth, being so close, just off the screen. And when they put them in orbit, they put the Stereo A a little bit closer to the Sun so it would move faster and get out ahead of the Earth. They put Stereo B and a little bit further from the Sun and made it have a slower orbit. That's why it keeps falling behind. My biggest question is why didn't they put something on there to where they could take and change the orbits at right about the time they got opposite of the Sun? Because now they just keep falling further away. A gets further ahead and B gets further behind, and now they're all out of sync. They're way in back of the Sun from the Earth now, and they're just going to keep getting further away. So it's not exactly a very advantageous position to be in if you're trying to monitor the space between the Earth and the Sun. It would have been nice if they could have adjusted the orbit about the time it got 90 degrees from the Sun. I guess that was out of their budget. when they first started, they weren't getting the same type of anomalies we're getting now with the background subtraction. Now we're getting the double planets. Before, you were getting the dark areas on either side. Now we're actually getting the 24-hour cycle of the planets doubling, basically. You're seeing two of them. Here comes Venus again with its flare down here. And here's the other reflection again. It's opposite of the center from the Venus. And the flare again as it leaves, pointed toward the center of the screen. That flare over here as it arrives, pointed toward the center of the screen. Here's your reflection up here. You see it changes to where it always points toward the center of the screen as it goes around. I guess I'll end this first one here when it gets to 2008, and make a second video of the other few years. Looks like it's getting really out of sync now. So we'll take and continue on the next video. So that's all for now. I hope that was helpful.